The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said to his apostles, "A disciple is not above his teacher, nor a servant above his master. It is enough for the disciple to be like his teacher, and the servant like his master. If they have called the master of the house Beelzebub, how much more will they malign those of his household? So have no fear of them, for nothing is covered that will not be revealed, or hidden that will not be known. What I tell you in the dark, utter in the light. And what you hear whispered, proclaim upon the housetops. And do not fear those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather, fear him who can destroy both soul and body in hell. And not to spare a soul for the penny, and not one of them will fall to the ground without your father's will. But even the hairs of your head are all numbered. Fear not, therefore, you are of more value than many sparrows. So everyone who acknowledges me before men, I also will acknowledge before my Father who is in heaven. But whoever denies me before men, I will also deny before my Father who is in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, there is nobody who is not afraid. There is no president who is not afraid. There is no king who is not afraid. There is no mother or father who is not afraid. Every man is afraid. The first time fear is recorded in the scriptures is when Adam and Eve sinned against God. And God appeared from the blues, and they were hiding themselves from God. And they said, "We are afraid because we are naked." Fear is part of the things God created and is innate in man. But the fundamental question is, what are you afraid of? What I am afraid of may be different of what you are afraid of. Some persons are afraid of poverty. Some persons are afraid of their reputation being destroyed. Some persons are afraid of coming down on the social ladder. Many things, many things. But today again, the Lord Jesus tells us what to be afraid of and what not to be afraid of. Beloved in the Lord, come to reflect about it. Go and check history. Go and check any society. Even our religious institution, go and check those who have made progress. They are the fearless ones. Even the fearless ones, so to say, they are afraid of something. The Lord Jesus is telling us today to have a healthy fear, not unhealthy fear. Beloved, you know, sometimes we are afraid of losing our friends who are dear to us, losing their relationships. Sometimes we are afraid of even losing our jobs, yes. Sometimes we are afraid of going off from that thing that seems to give us life. We are afraid of ostracization. We are afraid of many things. These things, most of them are very visible. But we are not afraid of becoming alienated to the kingdom of God. We are not afraid of God not being our friend any longer because we cannot see God. We are not afraid of sometimes losing our relationships with God. We are not afraid of that. Some spouses are afraid of losing their spouse, but they are afraid of losing God. Some persons are afraid of losing their jobs, more than they are afraid of losing God. If you check it very well, the root of it is faithlessness. Faithlessness. Faithlessness and lack of love and lack of the sense of what is urgent, lack of the sense of what is most essential and what is most necessary. And so we need the light of grace. We need to pray for the light of grace, the grace of God to hold on to the things, to recognize those things that are most essential in our lives. And for the fact that when we hold on to those things that are most essential in our lives, these other things become necessary. They become. Because even if there are evil men in the world, and they are the ones that dictate those who are to occupy particular positions, but because as a man, you are concerned about the most essential thing, and you are a focused man, then they will necessarily need you. They will call upon you. They will call upon you to come and take that position because you are the most best fitted person for that position. So, beloved, Jesus is telling us today not to be afraid of persecution, not to be afraid of invoking his name, not to be afraid of making his name known in a world that has lost its moral compass. Rather, to be afraid of losing our relationships with him. And so the fundamental question is, what are you afraid of? What am I afraid of? If somebody is telling you to come and do something that is evil, and you are telling the person, no, I cannot, and the person tells you, fear, fear, tell the person, thank you, I like this kind of fear. That is a healthy fear. So, beloved in the Lord, courage should not be shown in stupid things. Courage should not be shown in mundane things. Fearlessness should not be shown in things that are irrelevant to the human person, irrelevant to our faith. Fearlessness should be shown in the most essential things of life. The things that pertain to the soul. For the things that pertain to the soul also rob the things that pertain to the body.